Now today we are going to discuss one more topic in chemistry, that is atoms, molecules and elements and compounds, how we can classify the matter. Now one by one we are going to discuss. Now today topic is very clear, the fundamentals of chemistry, what are atoms, molecules and elements and compounds. Matlab, what is a classification of matter? How matter is classified, physical classification and chemical classification. Chalo, what is an atom? For your kind information, according to Dalton, atom is the smallest particle which is invisible, indivisible. We can't see our naked eye. That means this is the smallest particle which cannot be divided into some other fundamental particles. According to Dalton only what I am telling. So once again, according to Dalton, what is an atom? Is atom is the smallest particle which is invisible, indivisible, we can't see our naked eye. This is an atom according to Dalton only. Of course, further theories prove that atom is again divided into, subdivided into some fundamental particles. But first we can define what is an atom. Atom, now we can see. Acha, atom is the basic unit of the matter, means the smallest particle in the matter is nothing but atoms only according to Dalton, and that consists of a nucleus surrounded by electrons only. Let us discuss what is this. But atoms doesn't exist independently except noble gases. Atoms are participates in bonding, whereas molecules are not participating in bonding only. Atoms having no independent existence only. Atoms are depends upon other substance only. So there is no independent existence except noble gases. So right. So once again, atom. What is meant by atom? Atom is the smallest particle in matter which is invisible, indivisible, and cannot take part in bonding. So there is no independent existence. So doesn't exist as independently. Now see how these electrons are revolving around the nucleus. So inside the atom, some neutral charges are there and positive charge also there. Now you can see positive charge, some color positive charge hai. See here, these are electrons hai, and this is a positive charge protons hai. प्रोटॉन्स हैं। अच्छा देखो, ये वाला न्यूट्रॉन्स है, दिस इज ए न्यूट्रॉन्स है. बट अकॉर्डिंग टू डाल्टन, एटम इज द स्मॉलेस्ट पार्टिकल. बट फर्दर थ्योरीज प्रूव दैट एटम अगेन सब डिवाइडेड इनटू इलेक्ट्रॉन, प्रोटॉन एंड न्यूट्रॉन. सो सी, दिस इज वंस अगेन, दिस इज हाउ दिस कैन बी रिवॉल्व अराउंड द न्यूक्लियस. नाउ यू कैन सी दैट इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर रिवॉल्व अराउंड द न्यूक्लियस. बट inside the atom, so positive charge is also there, negative charge also there. Negative charge is particles, inside the atom, positive charge is proton, and the neutral is nothing but neutrons also present. So simple basic unit of matter is atom. Inside the atom, what are there? Inside the atom, proton and neutron. Outside the nucleus, what is there? Electrons are revolving around the nucleus only. This is a basic unit of the atom only. The basic unit of the atom doesn't exist independently except noble gases only. And atoms can take part in chemical bonding only. Like a hydrogen atom, for a hydrogen atom, so suppose I am writing like this. Acha, hydrogen atom and molecule will form like, of course it is exothermic reaction only. Atoms can take part in bonding to get a compound or a molecule only. But atoms having no independent existence, it depends upon other atoms only. The atoms are more reactive, not stable only, because in order to stabilize, they lose some energy, potential energy also. But anyhow, this is basic unit. Atom consists of nucleus. Outside the nucleus, electrons are. Inside the nucleus, are proton and neutrons are. Acha, proton and neutrons is nothing but nucleons are. Acha, proton and neutron inside the nucleus, which are called nucleons. Nucleons are present in nucleus. That's what is called nucleons, right? This is a basic unit. are the same thing. Every atom is composed of nucleus, and outside the nucleus electrons are there. Inside the nucleus, electron protons are also there. Electron proton, what we call as a nucleons only, because which are present in nucleus is called nucleons. अच्छा देखो, this is a nucleus है. Remember, this is a nucleus है. Inside some neutral ion and positive ion. So inside what are there? That those are nothing but nucleons ion. And outside the nucleus, electrons are revolve around the nucleus. So outside the nucleus, you can see.
I have a doubt, sir.
Yes, tell me.
So what is mean by nucleus and neutron?
What is it mean by?
Nucleus and neutron.
अच्छा न्यूक्लियस इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम न्यूट्रॉन है. न्यूट्रॉन इज सम मास है. न्यूक्लियस इज द पॉइंट वेयर एंटायर लाइक प्रोटॉन न्यूट्रॉन्स आर कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड. वन पर्टिकुलर सेंटर ओनली एंटायर मास इज कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड. दैट पर्टिकुलर सेंटर दे कॉल्ड एज अ न्यूक्लियस वन. न्यूट्रॉन्स आर डिफरेंट है. इन साइड द न्यूक्लियस न्यूट्रॉन्स आर प्रेजेंट बिकॉज ऑलमोस्ट ऑल द मास इज कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड वन पर्टिकुलर सेंटर. यू कैन सी दैट हियर मोस्ट ऑफ द एटम इज वेकेंट ओनली. You see, most of the atom is vacant only. The only thing is in the circular, see blue color there. That is called nucleus only. Very small portion. I will tell you one simple thing. If you are interested in playing cricket or watching cricket, I am telling you a very simple thing. The entire ground is an atom. Entire ground is an atom.
Okay, sir.
The cricket pitch or cricket ball, what we are using, that is called nucleus only.
Uh-huh.
Very small. The radius of nucleus is very, very, very small when compared to radius of the atom only.
Okay, sir.
The smallest portion where entire mass is concentrated, that is called nucleus only. Inside the nucleus, nucleus are present. Outside the nucleus, electrons are revolve around nucleus. Since electron mass is almost negligible only, we should not consider the mass of the electrons. Right? Chalo.
Okay, thank you.
I think your doubt is clear.
Yes, sir.
Acha, you are always welcome to ask me doubts. This is a very good move. So I am suggesting to all the students also, you have any doubt, please ask me, then and then only I can clarify your doubts. Chalo. Now see the electrons. Electrons are revolve around the nucleus one, but inside the nucleus, proton and neutron, nothing but nucleons. Actually, this is atom. The overall, in brief, what is an atom? What is a nucleus? What is a nucleons? Once again, I am writing over here nucleons. Achha, these are called nucleons. Nucleons. Nucleons are nothing but protons plus neutrons. Nucleons are nothing but protons plus neutrons. Right? Now, chalo. Simple, brief description. Achha, dekho, electrons are how revolve around the nucleus. Of course, don't go for behind, because further theories prove that electrons revolve around nucleus in circular path, elliptical path. That is different. We are going to discuss after the theories. Bohr's theory, Sommerfeld theory, several theories are there. How electrons are revolve around the nucleus. Here electrons are revolve around the nucleus. You can see that. Is it clear? It is visible? Chalo. So in this manner, electrons are revolve around the nucleus. Chalo. Achha, nucleus is made up of what? Protons and neutrons. Neutrons only. Achha, only one hydrogen is having no neutrons. Everybody might know that, except hydrogen. Except hydrogen. So for a kind of information, achha, hydrogen is nothing but H11. Here number of protons are 1. Because atomic number 1 is number of protons are also 1. So atomic number is nothing but number of protons and number of electrons. Shall I write like this? Atomic number is nothing but number of protons or number of electrons. Both are same. Number of electrons. Chalo, you see the hydrogen, their hydrogen. You see hydrogen over here, atomic number is 1, number of protons are 1, number of electrons are 1, but for a kind information, number of neutrons are mass number minus A minus Z. I think we can discuss later classes, right? But I will give this simple information for you. How to find out number of neutrons, A minus Z only. Achha, A is mass number also 1, and atomic number also 1. That's why number of neutrons are 0. That's why this point is written over here. Most of the elements, most of the atoms having protons and neutrons inside the nucleus, except hydrogen, because hydrogen may there is no neutrons, only protons. Other than hydrogen, remaining all elements, all atoms are having both protons and neutrons inside the nucleus only. That's why I clarified your doubts. Chalo. Next. Chalo, how electrons are revolving around the nucleus? Achha, a neutron hai, a proton hai. Right? Simple description only here. Achha, that proton and neutron together is called nucleons. Achha, very clear. It's very clear. Now you can see that. You can see that. Inside the nucleus, protons also there, neutrons also there. Proton, neutron together we call it as nucleons. So how electrons are revolving around the nucleus? This is a simple brief description of atom only. Don't be panic. Further, we can discuss in detail explanation about theories of the atomic theories. We can discuss. Right? Sure. Achha, I said that previously one student asked a doubt. Sir, what is a nucleus means? Here, see, I think what I said, almost all the mass is concentrated, focused in a particular center. That particular center is nucleus. Of course, Rutherford discovered the nucleus. What is the nucleus means? What they given percentage. Achha, don't worry about the percentage. Theoretically, you can remember almost all the mass is focused, located, concentrated in a particular center. This particular center, what we call as a nucleus one, right? Chalo. Achha, atom is a neutral. Everybody knows atom is a neutral. Any atom is a neutral one. So iska matlab kya hai? What is meant by neutral is nothing but they have protons, they are electrons, they are neutrons. So electrons are, everybody knows, a negatively charged particle. Protons are positively charged particle, a neutron is supposed to be neutral one. Otherwise, then only entire atom is a neutral one. So they given this point is, so atom is having proton, neutron, and electron. Atom is a neutral. How it become a neutral? Electrons are negatively charged, protons are positively charged, so neutrons are neutral. Of course, you studied in 8th, 9th, 10th standard, cathode rays experiment, CRT tube experiment. So discovery of electron, discovery of proton, everything, discovery of neutron. I think you might understand all the things in 10th standard also. So don't worry. If any doubt, in between also you can ask me. I can clarify your doubts. Chalo. Achha, what is the meaning of this? What is the meaning of this? Achha, anybody can see this picture, you can see that. Achha, I will tell you in simple manner. Achha, I think you studied, whether you studied in CBSE or State Board also, you studied in atomic structure, K, L, M, N shell, like that. Am I right? You studied about K, L, M, N shells. Suppose K shell. Suppose I consider helium atom. Helium atomic number 2. Matlab, 2 electrons are there around the nucleus and 2 protons are there. And 2 protons are there inside the nucleus. Of course, neutrons also present. 2 neutrons also present. Achha, these are negatively charged, these are positively charged. These are negatively charged, these are positively charged. So between 2 oppositely charged, there is a force of attraction. So this attraction, what this is called, electromagnetic force of attraction. Wo electrostatic force of attraction between oppositely charged ions. What they call as nuclear charge. Technical term we are using, nuclear charge. Nuclear charge. Technical term, further we are going to use the nuclear charge. The outer electrons which are present, outer electrons are more attraction towards the nucleus because nucleus is having positive charge. So this force of attraction between the electrons and protons, what they call electrostatic force of attraction, simply they call electromagnetic force. Right? So once again you can check it. between proton and electron the force of attraction hai. So we know some atoms are bigger size, some are very small size. So like what is happening over here, why contraction take place, why expansion take place? Because of nuclear charge region only. Because in periodic classification we are going to discuss in detail what is a nuclear charge, how to calculate nuclear charge, right? I will give you this class, I will give the basic information for you only. Acha, this is very simple. Like charges are repel each other, unlike charges are attract each other. Acha, you can see like charge, whenever like charges are coming, they repel each other. Unlike charges are attract each other only. This is a phenomenon, it takes place in nucleus also. Nuclear force are very much stronger than electrostatic force of attraction also. Acha, this force which binds the nucleus is stable, that force what they call as electromagnetic force bolte hain, right? Now some students have doubt, sir, inside the nucleus protons also there, neutrons also there. So between the protons also there are repulsive forces, between the neutrons also repulsive forces, but between proton and neutrons there should be some attractive force, is called what, nuclear force. They call as nuclear force, a special type of force or nuclear force is called nuclear force, which is usually stronger than the electromagnetic force, which are usually stronger than electron. That is called nuclear force is 10 power 17 times stronger than electrostatic force of attraction, nothing but electromagnetic force of attraction. So nuclear force are very much, that's why nucleus is most stable. Atoms never be collapsed. Atoms are always most stable, even though inside the atom, inside the nucleus, protons, neutrons also present. Still the atom is the most stable. The reason is a mystery force is present inside the nucleus, that is called nuclear force, which is 10 power 17 times is more stronger than electromagnetic attraction between electrons and protons also. Acha, now what is a molecule? Now we conclude what is an atom is. According to Dalton, atom is the smallest particle which is invisible, indivisible, but which can take part in chemical participation, but there is no independent existence. That is called an atom. Acha, molecule kya hota hai? Acha, what is the fark? What is the difference between molecule and atom? Acha, more or less both are same. According to Dalton, atom is the smallest particle. But according to Maxwell also, gases are made up of molecules only. What they call as gases that you studied in 10th standard only. But now the point, all gas molecules are made with the tiny, large, discrete particles called as molecules. Acha, molecules also smallest particle, which are also invisible, indivisible, but cannot take part in chemical bonding. It is an independent existence also there. The simple difference is, atom, molecule, both are smallest particle, both are invisible, both are indivisible, but atoms can take part in chemical bonding, but molecule cannot take part in chemical bonding because it is independent existence possibility there. Now you can see. Acha, in a molecule is nothing but a group of atoms. Like CO molecule, suppose I am writing over here. Like some CO molecule, some N2 molecule, like C6H12O6, glucose, like methane molecule, like ammonia molecule. Acha, combination of a group of atoms, like atoms, different atoms. A group of different atoms. Acha, for example, water is also a molecule, nothing but compound. But element is different. Element is carbon and oxygen, nitrogen, like hydrogen. These are elements. Elements are different from molecules only. Acha, both are smallest particle, no doubt at all. Both are invisible, both are indivisible. But one is having independent existence, another one is having no independent existence. atoms only combined in simple multiple ratio, simple integer ratio, we get a molecules only. This is according to Dalton only, right? Chalo. Which can be independent exist. Acha H2 molecule for our kind of formation very simple. At room temperature, hydrogen is available in the form of H2, not hydrogen. At room temperature, hydrogen is not. Chalo. At room temperature, hydrogen is available in the form of H2. At room temperature, hydrogen in the form of N2 gas. At room temperature, oxygen is O2, not O. But atoms are having not independent existence, but these are having independent existence, and molecules are having. This simple bifurcation between atom and molecule. देखो एग्जाम्पल है, एग्जाम्पल है, वाटर मॉलिक्यूल है, ऑक्सीजन हाइड्रोजन हाइड्रोजन है, लाइक C2H6 है, ए ब्लैक इज नथिंग बट कार्बन है, व्हाइट इज कंसीडर्ड टू बी हाइड्रोजन है. नाउ वेरी सिंपल, ये ब्लैक कलर इज इंडिकेटेड एज दिस इज कार्बन है, दिस इज ऑल्सो कार्बन है, एंड दीज आर हाइड्रोजन, दीज आर हाइड्रोजन है. व्हाइट कलर बॉल्स आर नथिंग बट हाइड्रोजन, दीज आर हाइड्रोजन, दीज आर हाइड्रोजन, दीज आर हाइड्रोजन. लाइक ये रेड कलर बॉल इज नथिंग बट ऑक्सीजन है, hydrogen, hydrogen. Simple representation. How can represent molecules? Very simple manner. Acha, already discussed methane, ethane, water molecule, ammonia molecule, HF molecule, everything, O2 molecule, N2 molecule, anything is nothing but molecules. All. Acha, molecules are. See, molecules are distinguished from ions by their lack of electrical charge. Acha, ion is different from molecules. I will tell you simple example. I will tell you simple example. Acha, dekho CO3 2- ye carbonate ion hai. Ye ion hai. Radical bolte hain. This is called anion bolte hain. Radical hai. Ye ion hai. Sulfate ion hai. SO4 2- is sulfate hai. This is also ion hai. Because it carrying charge is ion, not only anion, cation also. NH4+ is a cation. Like hydronium ion also is a cation. But ab dekho molecule is NH3 hai, CH4 hai, HF hai, etc. C2H6 hai. Molecule does not carrying any charge. Some of the oxidation state in a molecule is supposed to be zero only. But here it carrying negative charge. So molecules are distinguished from ions by their lack of electrical charge. Molecules are neutral, but radicals carrying charge, whether negative charge or positive charge. What kind of radical? Acidic radical or basic radical? So depends upon that. Depends upon this. Right? Right? Chalo. But in quantum physics or organic chemistry and biochemistry, the term molecule is often used to less strictly, also being applied to the polyatomic ions. Of course, a group of atoms, whether carrying negative charge or positive charge, a group of atoms is called molecules. In simple manner, organic chemistry reaction mechanism we are using only. But obviously, correctly, strictly you are speaking that atom is different, ion is different. Molecule is different, ion is different. But some case organic mechanism we are using, later we can discuss this. As I already said, in gaseous state, in states of matter, the smallest particle, tiny particle, discrete particle, a large number of particle, what they call as molecules. But according to Dalton, that is called atom only. So atom molecule is more or less is same. More both are indivisible. But one can take part in bonding, molecule cannot take part in bonding, according to the Dalton. only atoms combine together to form a molecule is simple ratio. Maybe 1:1, 1:2, 1:3, simple ratio. Like ammonia molecule, like N2+3H2O. Like N2+3H2 gives rise to 2NH3. Acha, nitrogen and hydrogen 1:3 ratio, their volume combined, volumes combined, we get a molecule only. Simple ratio, multiple ratio, we get a molecule according to Dalton. Acha, this is one ambiguity is there, one exception is there. Noble gas are monatomic. Acha, we know generally gases atoms, sir. I will tell you generally gases atoms. Generally, like nitrogen gas hai, oxygen gas hai, like chlorine gas hai, like fluorine gas hai. Generally, gases atoms are molecular state. Generally, gases, these are called gaseous molecules. Generally, diatomic gases molecule hai. But noble gases, aap dekh lijiye, noble gases hai. Helium atom hai, neon atom hai, argon hai, krypton. Like xenon, radon, etc. But even though it is considered to be a molecular, nothing but we call as a van der Waals forces are existing. Van der Waals forces are existing in noble gases. That's why it is also considered to be a sometimes considered to be a molecules only. But different type. That is an atom. This is a molecule. Because in between the molecules, always force of attraction is van der Waals force, weak forces. In between the molecule, the force of attraction weak forces. Weak forces ko we define van der Waals forces. I think some students might heard about this word, but some students are new word. Van der Waals forces hai. Van der Waals forces ka matlab weak force of attraction. Weak force hai. In between any two molecules, the force of attraction weak hai. Noble gas also non-polar hai. Between the two noble gases also, the force of attraction is very weak hai. That's why. This is the one similarity is their molecule and noble gases. Weak force of attraction, that weak force of attraction, what we call it? One van der Waals force of attraction. Van der Waals force of attraction, what they call as weak forces. Right, sir. So a molecule may be homonuclear and it consists of atoms of single chemical element. अच्छा व्हाट इज मेंट बाय होमोन्यूक्लियर हेटरोन्यूक्लियर वेरी सिंपल होमोन्यूक्लियर क्या है द मॉलिक्यूल मेड विद सिमिलर काइंड ऑफ एलिमेंट्स लाइक N2 इज मेड विद ओनली नाइट्रोजन एटम्स O2 इज मेड विद ओनली ऑक्सीजन एटम्स बट वेर CO इज मेड विद कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड इज आल्सो गैस मेड विद कार्बन एंड ऑक्सीजन लाइक CH4 मेड विद कार्बन एंड हाइड्रोजन अमोनिया इज मेड विद नाइट्रोजन एंड हाइड्रोजन okay homonuclear matlab what is a homonuclear this is a homonuclear heteronuclear other than single atom maybe two atoms three atoms together we get a molecule is nothing but that is different heteronuclear homonuclear heteronuclear like atomicity is of course diatomic but it is a pentatomic tetraatomic how many atoms are present that is called atomicity Atomicity is nothing but number of atoms present in a molecule is called atomicity. Diatomic, of course, CO is a diatomic. Five atoms are there, pentatomic. Four atoms are there, tetraatomic. Right? Atomicity is different. But we know homonuclear and heteronuclear. For example, P4 also tetraatomic, but homonuclear. Only one kind. Achha, for a kind of formation, S8. Sulfur exists as S8. Phosphorus is P4. Nitrogen N2, oxygen is O2, hydrogen is H2 only. So this is called homonuclear, but these are heteronuclear. Heteronuclear, right? Chalo. Atoms and complex connected by a non-covalent bond. Acha, for example, I think this is very new for you, but that's why I will go for brief introduction for you. So one HF molecule I consider.
Chalo, another HF molecule also I consider. This is one molecule, this is one molecule, right? Achha, between the molecule, one kind of bond is, I am going to write, that is called hydrogen bonding. We call it as hydrogen bonding. We call, you see, fluorine is a more electronegative element, I can represent delta minus, negative charge. Hydrogen is a positive, delta plus. Between two oppositely charged, these are two different, these two are molecular. In between the molecule, the force of attraction, weak force, what we call as Van der Waals force. But fluorine is a more E-n value, this is a less E-n value, matlab less electropositive. Between the two atoms, the bond formed is nothing but hydrogen bonding. Achha, don't be panic, later classes I can explain in detail. But given hydrogen bonds, achha, whenever between the molecule, between the two molecule, ionic bonds are there. So these are generally not considered as a single molecule. These are not considered to be a single molecule. Because these are two different molecules. Between the two different molecules, hydrogen bonding is formed. So later we discuss what is hydrogen bonding. In further class, chemical bonding, we can discuss it. Now you can remember. So this kind of bonds also found between the molecules. Stronger than Van der Waals forces. This is nothing but hydrogen bonding also. Achha, classification of matter. Achha, previous class we discussed what is meant by matter. Anything that has a mass and occupies some space is called matter. Anything that has a mass and occupies some space. You take any object in the universe. Any object in the universe, nothing but matter only. I will take a pen, is a matter. Achha, aapke haath mein book hai, wo bhi matter hai. Table hai, wo bhi matter hai. Sab kuch hai, duniya mein sab kuch hai. All objects in the universe are nothing but matter only. So how matter classification? There are two types of classifications are there. Physical classification as well as chemical classification. Now you can see the classification of matter. See, anything that has a mass and occupies some space is called matter. Anything that has a mass and occupies some space is called matter. Now classification, dekh lijiye. Physical classification. Achha, physical classification, mein, I think we are going to discuss only three states. Of course, beyond three states, one more state, plasma state also there, liquid crystals also there. But the main important thing is three states only. Achha, solid state hai, liquid state hai, gaseous state hai. Achha, for your kind of information, in between, solid and liquid, one liquid crystals also there. Liquid crystals also there. Achha, beyond gaseous state, plasma state also there. Plasma state also there, but for your kind of information, because 11th and 12th syllabus, only three states are possible: solid, liquid, and gaseous state. You take any object in the universe, either of these five, any one state. Achha, for your kind of information, I will ask one simple doubt. Any students can answer to my question. Glass. Achha, glass belongs to which state? Anybody pick? Anybody can get the answer? Glass,
solid.
Okay, chalo, solid. And any other options? Any other options? Glass belongs to which state? Solid, liquid, gas?
Solid.
Achha, one answer is solid. Achha, you can frame objective questions also. Glass belongs to option A, solid state. Option B, liquid. Option C, gas. Option D, I will give liquid crystal. Glass is super cool liquid. I think you remember, glass is super cool liquid. Glass is not a liquid, glass is not a solid. In between solid and gas, liquid state. Super cool liquid. Glass is liquid state, we call as liquid crystal. Super cool liquid. Inhaling techniques, I think you studied somewhere else in 10th standard, 9th standard. Inhaling is nothing but soup. Slow cooling of the solid, it becomes a liquid state only. I think you get it. Glass is nothing but super cool liquid antam. Liquid ke maniki fluidity untundi. Am I right? Any students have objection? Liquid having only fluidity, solid having no fluidity. Am I right? Acha, can you observe in our houses, sir? Suppose your house is old building, you can see the windows. Windows, bottom of the windows thickness is more. Very difficult to pull the window. The reason is glass is a liquid. That's why flow of liquid from high level region to low level region. So lower level region mein, bottom mein, thickness increase ho raha hai. That's why they can stuck it. It's not easy to open the door only. If we're a very old building, 30 to 40 years old building, you can observe that. Since solid having no fluidity, but liquids are only fluidity only. Am I right? I think you get it. The point, glass is nothing but super cool liquid. But you take any object in the universe, solid, liquid, and gas. There are three states are possible, but beyond the state also liquid crystals and plasma state. Plasma state is nothing but which are near to the sun. Any object is ionized in plasma state only. Ourselves also, we can go for plasma state. We are ionized only. Anything is ionized in plasma state only. Clear? Chalo. Acha, now go to chemical classification. Chemical classification. Acha, chemical classification is pure substance, mixes, pure substance. Pure substance lo malli elements compounds unde. We can discuss later one by one. Acha, mixes lo manaki two types untai, homogeneous, heterogeneous. Later we discuss one by one example. What is homogeneous, what is heterogeneous anta. Homogeneous and heterogeneous. More than one kind of pure substance. Air, tea, this is a homogeneous mixture also. Achha, more than one kind of pure substance is called mixes. Tea, sugar, solution, edana kavachu. Okay, we can discuss some other examples. Achha, homogeneous, heterogeneous. Same, only one phase is nothing but homogeneous. Achha, I will tell you, I will ask you one simple question for you. Sugar solution is homogeneous, heterogeneous. Sugar solution. I'm asking one simple question. Sugar solution. Sugar solution is homogeneous or heterogeneous? Anybody? अच्छा sugar में क्या है? एक glass tube में मैंने पानी लिया, उसमें sugar डाल दिया. एक glass tube में पानी दिया, उसमें sugar add किया.
Sugar में dissolve.
I added sugar in water. I added sugar in water. What kind of mixer? Homogeneous, heterogeneous? Homogeneous only. Because throughout the solution, same taste. अच्छा अलग अलग taste नहीं होता है. Throughout the solution, same taste होता है. That is homogeneous. Only one phase है. अच्छा heterogeneous. Can you tell one example of heterogeneous? Like milk is heterogeneous. Blood, our blood is heterogeneous. Cloud is heterogeneous, gold is heterogeneous. So colloid, simply we call it colloid solution is called heterogeneous. Homogeneous is different from heterogeneous. Chalo. Same one kind of phase is called homogeneous. Achha, pure substance. Pure substance are two types on the elements on the two, compounds on the two. Contains single type of particle. Single type of particle like elements N2, O2, H2, like compound like CH4, NH3. This is called pure substance over there. No other impurities are, only pure substance. Achha, one element hai, another one compound. Achha, we discuss compounds and nothing but molecules. When elements are combined in simple multiple ratio, we get a compound or a molecule only. These compounds are and elements are. Dekho, compounds, this is simple classification, we can discuss one by one. Achha, matter classified into two, physical classification, chemical classification. Physical means solid and liquid and gas, only three important states are only given. Chemical classification, again mixes and pure substance. Mixes mein homogeneous, heterogeneous,
few substances mein two classification compounds and elements we can discuss one by one in detail. Chalo. Acha, what are elements? Only one kind of atoms, N2, O2, F2, Cl2. Only one kind of atom is nothing but element. Further, it cannot be decomposed into simple substance only. That is called elements only. Example, dekh lijiye. These are elements only. Pure substance made with only one kind. Sodium. You know sodium metal. Everybody knows sodium metal, copper metal, lithium metal, aluminium metal with only made with aluminium only. Aluminium foil we call it. Aluminium made with aluminium only. Sodium metal made with sodium atom only. Like copper metal is made with copper atoms only. Silver metal is made with silver atoms only. Right? This is called elements only. Acha, compounds containing two or more elements in different proportions, simple multiple proportions. We got a compound we call a molecule also. Example, dekho, H2O, CO2, NH3, etc. 2:1 ratio, here 1:2 ratio. These are called compounds only. We call previous discussion, we call it is called molecules also. Acha, now acha, there are two types of variable composition is there, one phase and different phase. What are homogeneous, what is heterogeneous? Acha, these mixes may be separated into pure substances by physical methods. Maybe filtration also, maybe hand picking also, different methods they are using. Okay, these are the mixture properties, but classification we are going to discuss. Variable composition, for example, brass, copper, zinc, brass and down, bronze metal, like gun metal, German steel, these are alloys. Alloys are nothing but different variable composition. Copper having like 22 karat gold bolte, 24 karat is pure. For example, very simple example, everybody might know, very simple example. Acha, 24 karat gold. Acha, 24 karat gold is element. I call it as element. Because gold is made with gold atoms only. 24 karat gold is element only. Acha, suppose 22 karat gold. Acha, it is having variable composition. Matlab 22 karat gold hai. Remaining two parts of what we use is copper only. And is alloy of gold and copper still is homogeneous. 24 karat gold is not useful to make ornaments. Acha, you can see anybody you are wearing ornament, that ornament is 22 karat, 21 karat, 20 karat gold. So we are using 22 karat, 21 karat, 20 karat gold. That is not a pure substance, that is called mixture only, because it is having variable composition only. Sometimes I may ask question, 24 karat is an example for element. Is not a compound, but 22 karat gold is an example for a mixer. What kind of mixer? Homogeneous. In the same phase only. Right? But different methods. If major variable composition having different properties. Right? Chalo. Achha, these are two types. Already discussed, homogeneous and heterogeneous. Heterogeneous. Dekho, example. Homogeneous mixer example hai. Have same composition throughout. Acha, one thing I would like to ask you. One simple question. Acha, most of the students, most of the person is drinking beverages like Pepsi, Coca-Cola, Exa, Sprite, etc. Everything. Acha, what you are drinking, Sprite or Coca-Cola? It is homogeneous or heterogeneous? Anybody? Good.
Acha, homogeneous.
Yes, very good. Homogeneous. You are drinking Rasna.
Yes, sir, it is homogeneous.
Homogeneous. Acha. Acha, milk.
मिल्क
हेटरोजीनियस.
अच्छा कैसा, हाउ मिल्क इज हेटरोजीनियस?
इट्स अ प्योर.
तो लेट मी डिस्कस. मिल्क में क्या होता है, लिक्विड लिक्विड ऑयल ड्रॉपलेट्स इन ऑयल ड्रॉपलेट्स एंड फैट इज डिसॉल्व्ड इन ऑयल ड्रॉपलेट्स. दैट्स व्हाई डिफरेंट फेज होता है, वी कैन डिस्कस लेटर ओनली. अच्छा एग्जांपल शुगर सॉल्यूशन एंड शुगर डिसॉल्व्ड इन वाटर. देख लीजिए एक डायग्राम देख लीजिए, शुगर डिसॉल्व्ड इन वाटर है, कैसा बनेगा शुगर डिसॉल्व्ड इन वाटर शुगर सॉल्यूशन. एंड गैसेस मिक्सचर, एयर इज नथिंग बट अ होमोजेनियस मिक्सचर ऑफ सेवरल गैसेस ओनली. We can't separate the air only easily. देखो homogeneous means throughout the solution same composition only. Now heterogeneous है, what we call as colloidal solution बोलते हैं, colloids है. अच्छा water corrosion कैसा होता है, homogeneous heterogeneous, obviously heterogeneous. Oil in water, oil in water is not homogeneous, heterogeneous. Sometimes suppose you take a oil in water in a one beaker, one bottle, shake vigorously, and put it in a in one table, and standing position, we can observe two layers. One oil layer, one water layer, one aqueous layer. It is not homogeneous. You can do the simple thing in your home. Take one bottle and put a kerosene and a water in that. And shake vigorously, and sometime within 2 to 3 minutes or 5 minutes, and kept somewhere else in undisturbed position. After 10 minutes, you can watch this, watch that bottle, and you observe two layers. One is oil layer, one is water layer. Depends upon density. अच्छा oil का density कम है, less है, then it is a bottom layer. Oil का density more है, it is upper layer. So water and kerosene is nothing but a heterogeneous, nothing but colloidal solution. अच्छा मिल्क आल्सो लाइक क्लाउड आल्सो एक्सेट्रा राइट. अच्छा टुडे वेरी सिंपल थिंग, वंस अगेन आई रिपीट व्हाट वी डिस्कस टुडे. एन एटम आई विल ब्रीफ यू विद इन 1 or 2 minutes एंड द क्लास व्हाट वी डिस्कस. व्हाट इज एन एटम, एटम इज द स्मॉलेस्ट पार्टिकल according to Dalton, which is invisible, indivisible, can take part in chemical bonding, no independent existence, right? This is called atoms. And what is a molecule then? So molecule also is smallest particle according to the Maxwell, which is invisible, indivisible, but cannot take part in bonding because it is having independent existence only. This is called molecules. अच्छा वी डिस्कस इधर एटम और मॉलिक्यूल, व्हाट आर द पार्ट्स आर प्रेजेंट, न्यूक्लियस न्यूक्लियंस, आउटसाइड द न्यूक्लियस इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर देयर, हाउ दे आर रिवॉल्विंग अराउंड द न्यूक्लियस, इनसाइड द एटम व्हाट आर देयर प्रोटॉन एंड न्यूट्रॉन, व्हाट दे कॉल्ड कलेक्टिवली कॉल्ड एज न्यूक्लियंस आल्सो. सो देन वी डिस्कस क्लासिफिकेशन, व्हाट इज अ मैटर, क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ मैटर इज नथिंग बट एनीथिंग दैट हैज अ मास एंड ऑक्युपाई सम स्पेस. नाउ क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ मैटर, फिजिकल क्लासिफिकेशन, केमिकल क्लासिफिकेशन. फिजिकल क्लासिफिकेशन में स्टेट्स, सॉलिड स्टेट, लिक्विड स्टेट एंड गैसी स्टेट. ऑफकोर्स इन बिटवीन सॉलिड एंड लिक्विड लिक्विड क्रिस्टल, बियॉन्ड गैसी स्टेट प्लाज्मा स्टेट इज देयर. नाउ केमिकल क्लासिफिकेशन में देयर आर टू टाइप्स हैं, प्योर सब्सटेंस है, प्योर सब्सटेंस इज मेड विद ओनली वन काइंड ऑफ सब्सटेंस ओनली, एंड होमोजीनियस हेटरोजीनियस नथिंग बट मिक्सेस. एग्जाम्पल्स ओनली वी डिस्कस, राइट. टुमारो नेक्स्ट क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस व्हाट आर आइसोटोप्स, आइसोबार्स, isotones, isodiapers, etc. And followed by how to write the formula of the compound. Everything we are going to discuss. Achha, today topic, any doubt you have, you can ask me. Because this today, see, today most of the, most anywhere else online classes are going on. Online classing, matlab ye nahi hai. I am only teaching, you are only listening. Make our classes interactive class only, so that it is very helpful for you only. Whenever you have doubt, please ask me, then and there only I can clarify your doubts. Don't hesitate to ask me, freely you can ask me, I can clarify your doubts, right? Here in WhatsApp group also, we create one WhatsApp group, another also you can post the doubts. we can clarify our doubts. Anything else? Any doubts we have? Now today we can wind up the classes. Thank you. Thank you very much. Tomorrow again same time. Chalo.